All right. Now, I normally do this with somebody, and I'm a little ticked off that I don't see. Where's Doug Jones? Come on, Jones, where are you? Are you here? Where is he? Man, we got to do this with him. Where is he? He's always late for everything. Jeez, Jones, where are you? Always has to have the most attention. Always, always, always has to have the most attention. You're looking good. Did you wear your jammies? I am so proud. Where did you get this fabulous outfit, dude? Awesome. Nice. Here, you have a microphone. You want to talk? Go ahead.
I wore a great sweater last year. It should have won.
You don't get to win. You're not in the contest. You're the MC.
So I wore my pajamas this time.
Awesome.
Their shoes?
They're very nice.
The shoes.
I like the shoes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So everybody, give me an S.
S.
Give me a W.
W.
Give me E.
E.
A.
I don't know. What are you spelling?
Give me A.
A.
Give me T.
T.
Give me E.
E.
Give me R.
R.
What's that spell?
Sweater.
Sweater. What's a sweater?
Yeah.
Sweater.
You know, are you
sweater
wearing
contest.
A sweater? I don't see a sweater
no,
here.
No, I didn't win last year.
I know. So you just said dressed like an elf.
Yes, ma'am. Oops.
That is awesome. Whoops. I hate it when you lose your shoe.
I know.
Okay. All right, we have to introduce you to the judges, our wonderful panel of experts here on the front row. Representing the pastoral staff, please stand and wave when it's your turn, is Pastor Bill Ray. Representing the Kenneth Hagin Ministries Executive Office is Amanda Gregorich. Representing the athletic department, the wonderful, the fabulous coach of the women's basketball team, Carrie Sharp. Representing RBTC Admissions Office and our head judge, all you better suck up to her, this is Brenna Sutherland. Representing the instructors for the second time, no, you've done this several times, you are like an expert, 2, 3, 4, 10 times. Representing the instructors, Kirk Dubois. Representing the students, we have Mr. Daniel Clark. And we have Sheila Densler. All right. That's very nice. Very contributionary. Thank you very much. All right. What we're going to do is have the sweater people. That's you. I'm so proud. You look fabulous. Tell your neighbor they look fabulous. Okay. Judge number 4 wants you to know that he can be bribed with chocolate. If you have any in your little bags or anything, you can. Okay, so what I'm going to have you guys do is just kind of come down the stairs and file by the judges and come back up again, okay? While our lovely sound man plays some fabulous Christmas music on your market set, go. So just come down here and show them your stuff. Strut your stuff. Yeah, yeah, we're strutting it. We're strutting it.
Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.
Oh my gosh, it's wonderful. I love it. Look at them. They're so cute. I love it. Oh my gosh. Fabulous. Really, you guys have outdone yourself. I am loving these sweaters. Oh my gosh, who's videoing this right now? We need some video. This is gonna go viral. I'm telling you, this is awesome. All right. Thank you, Ben. Now, you guys who have sweaters, please hold your numbers forever. Do not ever drop those numbers until, like, tomorrow, okay? Keep them forever and ever. All right. Now Doug is going to do the part of the program that I know you all enjoy the most. He's going to lead the sweater wearers in a song. Are you ready? You feel free to sing along. I don't know what they're going to sing. Here he comes.
And a one, and a two, and a... We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Good tidings we bring to you and your...
Good tidings to Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
We wish everybody says we wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yay. Awesome, awesome, awesome. All right, judges, that was it. That was your time. Are you good? Are you happy? Are you done? We need you to be done. I see the head judge. She's still writing. Now, I want you to know that after the judges are done, there will be, I'm going to pick one, Karen's favorite, Doug's going to pick one, and we're going to have a people's choice. So you guys are going to participate, so I hope that you are watching your fellow classmates and deciding which sweater you like the best, because we're going to have a people's choice award. Okay, judges, almost done. Here we go. Deliberate, deliberate, because this is really important, you know. They got to be sure they get the right persons with the right award. These fabulous awards that we have purchased at Neiman Marcus. I'm kidding. Does anybody know what Neiman Marcus is? We didn't go there. Somebody have their video camera, I hope, because really.
Everybody join me.
You're doing it. You look good. Don't do it, Brother Bill. All right, here we go. Thank you, ma'am. Are you ready? Drum roll, please. We have several categories of sweater. Oh, Jones, are you ready with your prize box? Yeah. Okay, first one is for the funniest sweater. Now, the funniest sweater, it makes you laugh, it makes everyone around you laugh, and it will still make you laugh in January. And the prize for this wonderful sweater is a box of Thin Mints, all right? And the winner is number 22. Come on down. No, over here, up here, Ernie. You have to get your picture taken with us. Ernie wins the Thin Mints. All right, smile. All right, we're good. Would you go down there, Ernie, and see that lovely woman right there waving at you? She wants your name and all that kind of stuff. All right, number two is for most creative. This sweater is unlike any other, which, hello. All right, we've never seen anything like that before. It's very unusual, and they put some thought into it. And the prize for this wonderful, most creative sweater is a mirror, because I think they might need one. All right. And the winner is number 20. Woohoo! Look at that. Tell us your name, ma'am.
Jennifer.
This is Jennifer. All right, smile. Good job. Would you go down there and tell Laura all your good information? Way to go. Fabulous, really. Fabulous sweater. All right, most Rhema. All right. Now, this sweater has some aspect representing something from Rhema. It's done with excellence, of course, because this is Rhema. And it has Rhema-like details on it. All right. And the wonderful prize for that is a book light, so you can read all of your book reading before, you know, you're reading for classes at night. All right. And the winner is number 18. Yay. You have to look at the pictures on her sweater. Turn around and show us the picture of Doug Jones on the back. He looks like some kind of zombie. I'm not sure what we're, you know, cone head. Okay, smile, ma'am. Good job. Would you go down there and tell her your name and information? Okay, number four category is, wow, you worked hard on that. This sweater is obviously took more than 5 minutes to put together. It's perhaps the sweater, it's probably difficult to get into. The artwork or the craft skills are evidence, and they have the thought, how many hours did we waste on that? Okay? And the prize for this wonderful thing is a crossword puzzle book. They have a lot of time on their hands. No. Okay. And the winner is number 8. Number 8. Who's number 8? All right, come on up. Usually you come on down, but we're coming on up. That is quite fabulous. Look at that. Wow-wee, wow-wee. All right, tell us your name.
Jessica.
It's Jessica. She wins.
Turn her up.
What's on the back? It says Mark 11:23, Bible training, college. Don't shout me down just because I'm preaching good. I like it. All right, would you go down there and tell Laura all of your information? All right, the next category is the sweater most likely to embarrass whoever you're with. We don't even need to say any more about that. And the winner, the prize for that is a lighter. It lights candles, and Doug says it's so they can set it on fire. All right. And the winner is number 14. You know it. I like this one the best. What can I say? It would have won my choice because it's got a coffee pot. Do you know these machines turn water into coffee? Isn't that awesome? All right, here, let's pose for your photo. Wait, tell us your name.
Aaron Woker.
He even tells his last name. He's not ashamed. Tell Laura your information.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, next category is Judge's Choice. And this means this is the sweater that really is outstanding, but it didn't fit any other category. Oh, and their prize is a lovely Christmas mug. Okay, and the winner is number 2. Yay, number 2. We like it. That's pretty ugly. You got to be a real man to wear a sweater like that. Tell us your name.
Taylor.
This is Taylor.
Seriously? You got a prize for this? Mine was a whole lot better last year than that.
They can't hear you. What'd you say?
Mine was better than that last year. You got a prize.
I know. I'm sorry. Don't be a powder. All right. Now we have my choice. All right, are you ready for this? My choice. Hallelujah. I know I have to pick number 9. Julie, I think this is fabulous. You can't even tell, but she has lights on that. And her prize is earplugs because
I don't want to listen to you.
Because Jones doesn't want to listen to me brag about my choice. All right, Julie, here, come and get your picture. Fabulous. Okay, it's your turn, Jones. Next we have Doug's choice, MC's choice, and the prize is?
Hand deodorizer. Hand deodorizer.
I think it's soap.
Is that soap?
Yeah. Okay. All right, and here, you need a microphone for this. Yeah. Who's your choice? Hang on. Close your eyes.
Wait.
Nobody wants to see that. You're scaring me. This is Rhema Jones. Come on.
To the person who gave the least amount of thought to any of this, number 7.
I like it. It's falling
Seriously.
Down. Look, it's cute.
Seriously, it's a
Here.
T-shirt
yeah,
with stuff
see,
glued on
I think that's so cute. Sweaty. Tell us your name.
Thomas.
This is Thomas. All right. Yeah, keep your number forever. All right, now this is your guys' turn. All right? Now, if you've already won, would you guys move, like, over here? If you've already won a prize, move over here so they know who to vote for and who not to vote for, because you can't be winning twice. It's kind of like a rule. All right, this is the People's Choice Award. Can you guys, on this step down one more so they can see everybody in the back real good? There you go. Now, hold up your numbers. Be loud and proud. Show everybody your wonderful sweater. Oh, yes, okay. So now clap the loudest for the sweater that you like the best, okay? How about this one? Okay, good deal. Okay, how about this one? Okay, how about this one? I think Annie Jones has this rigged. Okay, how about this one? Yeah, how about this one? How about this one? Hold up your number. Fan club, fan club. How about this one?
Ooh.
We might have to have a clap off. How about this one? All right. How about number 16? I like the hands. All right, how about this one? Okay, hold up your numbers. Oh, how about this one? Okay, how about this one? Yeah, okay, how about this one? Okay. And how about this one? I really like that one. Okay, we're gonna have to have a clap off. And number 17, step down. Number 19, step down. Number 3, step down. Number 5, step down. 12, I'm sorry. 5, you can step down too. Okay. Okay, all right, you ready? Now pick from these, okay? Clap off. How about for this one? I like it. How about this one? All right, how about this one? Oh, okay, how about this one? Wow, all right. I think people should, what's your number on the end? 3, all right, I think number 3 wins. And here is your prize. Come on up here. It's a laundry bag because everybody needs one. Come and get your picture taken. Tell us your name.
Jessica.
Jessica. All right. Good job, Jessica. All right. You guys can go stand back up there. We're going to have a group shot. I know it for sure. All right. Well, I think that, do you want to give that prize to somebody? You want to take that home with you? You don't know what you want to do. He's thinking. You want to give it to Christy? Yeah, do we see Christy's lovely, ugly attempt at ugly? It says UGLY all over her sweater. She's got no alibi. She wins potholders. What? Oh, come up, Christy. You have to stand with them. All right, I guess that's the end. We have to stand down in front and have our picture taken with them because we are fabulous. All right, thank you very much for coming. It's been a lovely delight to have you. How about another round of applause for our wonderful sweater wearers, the fearless, the proud. All right, and you are dismissed.